You're listening to Winnipeg's Classic 107. My name is Simon Rusnak, and I'm delighted to say that I've been joined by a group of musicians from the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra here to spread some festive cheer. Horns aplenty this morning, joined by Patricia, Aiden, Callie, and Mitch. Thank you all for being here. Before I invite you over to the microphone, we're going to hear a little bit of music, so let's jump right into it, a 107 live performance. Live in the Classic 107 studio, we just heard four horns of the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra, and I'm joined now by Principal Horn, Patricia Evans. Good morning.
Good morning.
Let me adjust that mic for you there. That sounded absolutely lovely.
Thank you.
You know, I feel like it's taken on new meaning, though, with this incoming Colorado low. The weather outside, not too frightful right now. The horns sounding delightful, but we are indeed going to see lots of snow.
Yeah, so I hear. But I have to say, horns are kind of the ultimate holiday instrument, the ultimate Christmas instrument.
Yeah, says the horn player, but tell us more about why you think that is, Patricia.
Well, you see them hanging all over the place as decorations, for one thing. I mean, they are aesthetically pleasing to look at as well as beautiful to listen to. So whenever anybody says, French horn, which one is that? I say, well, picture a Christmas wreath. It's the round one, the circular one. In brass.
Yeah, well said. It's true. You do see plenty of horns this time of year. And we've also been seeing plenty of you performing. It has been a very busy time of the year for the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra musicians. Tell us a little bit about what that's been like.
Well, I mean, it's our first really busy patch, I would say, since COVID. So it's, you know, getting back in the swing of things. We've been heading out of town a little bit on our holiday tour. So we were in Steinbach last week. We'll be in Portage-la-Prairie tonight. We'll be in Brandon on Sunday. And we're also doing the Messiah this week.
Mm-hmm.
So that'll be Saturday night at Centennial Concert Hall. We're also, last week we had a John Denver special. We did a Celebration of Nations, was a collaboration with Folklorama for our Pops program. It's just been really, really busy. But yeah, that's how it is.
That's how it is. And like you say, it's been a long time since it's been this busy.
Yes.
It is so wonderful for you to take the time to be here this morning and to spread a bit of festive cheer. And we're going to be hanging out over the next little while as you continue to perform some selections. You mentioned, the fact that Messiah's coming up this weekend.
Yes.
And I think you've got a little bit of Messiah queued up. Is that something we're going to be hearing?
Yeah, there are no horns in the Messiah.
Yeah.
So we have prepared a special treat for you. With, you know, horns actually playing the Hallelujah Chorus.
All right, well, let's hear it. Here are four horns of the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra, Patricia, Aiden, Callie, and Mitch performing the Hallelujah Chorus.
Mm-hmm.
live in the Classic 107 studio. Four horns of the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra performing a wonderful arrangement of the Hallelujah Chorus from Handel's Messiah. They're going to be sticking around. More 107 live performances coming up just after this, beginning with a word from the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra. 8:30 in Winnipeg on this Tuesday morning. My name is Simon Rusnak, hanging out with the horn section of the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra, joined once again by Principal Horn, Patricia Evans. How wonderful was that arrangement? That was fantastic.
I know. We're so lucky we have a fellow horn player, Taryn Plamadon, if you're listening. Hi, Taryn, who arranged these books, Christmas busking books. And they work for 2 to 3 instruments or 4 to 5 instruments. So they're really flexible. And yeah, we're lucky to have him.
Well, that was exactly what I was going to ask about. Because, you know, just this past weekend on Saturday as part of the Virtuosi concert, I was singing with Husti, Ukrainian male chorus. And we did an arrangement of the Hallelujah Chorus for men's four-part. But we sang it in Ukrainian on top of that. So, I mean, I feel like there is every arrangement under the sun of the Hallelujah Chorus, but I can't say I've ever heard a version for four horns. So that's real lovely stuff.
Yeah, Husli, that must have been amazing.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. It was a great show to be part of.
We've done shows with you before, and it's just mind-boggling.
You certainly have. Well, hey, look, speaking of shows, we were just chatting about the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra performance of Handel's Messiah, which, of course, doesn't feature horns, which is what's particularly unique about that arrangement of the Hallelujah Chorus. That's coming up this weekend. You were chatting about all of the community outreach and the WSO in the province of Manitoba traveling around, and then looking ahead to just a few weeks' time, beginning on the 21st, another perennial favorite, Nutcracker's coming up.
Yeah, Nutcracker. A favorite of ours. We play Nutcracker from before Christmas all the way through the holiday until usually until the beginning of January. So we have, I don't know, maybe 9 performances, something like that, with the Royal Winnipeg Ballet.
Yeah, it's a busy one. I'm curious about that. You know, when you do these longer runs, because so often it is, you know, one night or maybe two nights of performance with the WSO show, this gives you the opportunity to really settle into things, doesn't it, as the performance progresses, right?
Yes. Yeah, for sure. And, you know, of course, so I've been with the orchestra for over 20 years now. So I've played a lot of Nutcrackers over the years. So for me, it's sort of like an old friend dusting off an old friend. But it is different every single year because we have new people every year and people at different stages in their careers and new dancers on stage, new conductors at the RWB. So, yeah, it's always a different and interesting experience.
Yeah, it keeps it fresh and keeps it festive. So that's coming up on the 21st. And you even have a little bit of Nutcracker queued up for us. It's like we planned this or something, but we really didn't.
We're so on top of it. Yeah, 8 o'clock in the morning, we're so on top of it.
Ain't that the truth? What are we going to hear from Nutcracker, just out of curiosity?
We're going to hear a little Sugar Plum Fairy.
Ooh, so lovely.
Followed by a special tune for any of you out there who maybe aren't feeling quite so festive right now.
All right. Back-to-back tracks as Patricia Evans makes her way back over, picks up her horn again as we continue with 107 live performances here in the Classic 107 studio. Thank you. the Classic 107 studio. We just heard You're a Mean One, Mr. Grinch, and before that, the Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairies, performed by the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra horn section. I'm going to invite Patricia back to the mic one more time while we got her here. You have been so generous with your performances this morning.
Well, we appreciate being asked to come.
Oh, well, hey, anytime. You're welcome anytime. I also want to point out for... those who are listening, they can't quite see, but you're all dressed
I know.
So festively.
We came all in our Christmas finery today. and when I said to everyone, oh, we should wear our ugly sweaters, which actually Mitch was featured in that last one.
Yeah,
that
she
was
did
like
great
a
job.
Fourth horn feature.
Yeah, yeah.
It was
yeah.
pretty awesome. But Mitch is kind of an ugly sweater specialist. She loves Christmas time and ugly sweater days and all that. So I said, we should wear our ugly sweaters. And everybody said, it's the radio, Patty. Why are we wearing ugly sweaters?
It's not just radio anymore. Yeah, they'll have to watch it online. It'll be up on the Classic 107 website later today. You also inspired me to wear a festive tie.
Oh, very
that
nice.
I borrowed just because I knew you were coming. And I know you always do a wonderful job of spreading cheer, both orally and visually, too. So before I let you go, you're going to do one more. We sort of heard the biting side of the horn there, especially with the fourth horn part with the Grinch. We're going to end with something a little bit sweeter, aren't we?
Yes. In Dulce Jubilo.
Yeah.
Or A Good Christian Men Rejoice, if you know the English version of that hymn. It's a beautiful arrangement, again, by our friend Taryn. So
what more is there to say? I'll let you take your seat again. Thank you all for being here this morning. Really appreciate you coming into the studio. And here's one more from the horns of the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra in Dulce Jubilo. Live in the Classic 107 studio, Patricia, Aiden, Callie, and Mitch of the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra spreading a bit of festive cheer with a few horn selections.